All right, so let's say you're going to drive about 1,100 miles, basically taking the kids from New York City to Disney World. Now imagine doing it at around 200 miles an hour in front of a combined 500,000 screaming fans. This past Sunday, NASCAR driver Kurt Busch attempted the double, competing in the Indy 500 in the afternoon, then flying down to Charlotte to race in the Coca Cola 600 in the evening. Here's his firsthand, unguarded account of his crazy day.
The whole atmosphere of Indianapolis and the 500, it's a grand stage and the world is watching.
My experience level on the IndyCar side is zero. I'll tell you, it's motorsports, but it's two completely different disciplines.
Going into something that I've never done before. There's, of course, the Thursday in one city, Friday in another city, Saturday in another city, Sunday in both.
I do things for a reason. Over the last couple years working with the Armed Forces Foundation, I've seen a lot that our military has gone through. And with this being Memorial Day weekend, to me it's an easy way to reflect and to show respect for our military. And to do 1,100 miles in one day, there's going to be the mental challenge, the physical challenge. And when you see these men and women who have served, that's the inspiration to go out there and do this.
When I walked through Gasoline Alley Sunday morning, it hit me at that moment of this was the 98th running of the Indy 500, and so many races have been won, and the hardship of it as well. The bad side effect is injuring yourself. Motorsports is a dangerous game. It's a risk. Is your heart telling you to do it? Is your brain telling you not to do it? But I felt as if this was the most prepared I've ever been in my life for something that I didn't know what I was getting into.
This 1,100 miles starts right now.
The first half of the race was going to be a learning experience, and I started to get comfortable with the car.
Check in on Kurt Busch and his bid. In his first Indianapolis 500, he took the green flag in 12th position, Kurt running in 15th now.
You have to use a sixth sense that you wouldn't think of in racing, and it's sound. Well, you think that the motor drowns out sound. It does, but you can hear other people's motors. And when somebody's close to you, you need to listen for them.
Kurt Busch in that last run, moving up. He's handled it like he's a veteran.
The check mark was lap 150. Accidents are gonna start to happen because drivers are now putting their cars on edge. So I knew turn two was gonna be a tough corner, and it was for me all day long. Others are likely to have trouble there too.
Busch and crash. There was debris in turn two.
I saw the impact. And when these cars hit the wall, they literally look like they explode. And I had to go as hard left as I could at a rate to not spin the car. If you get into the grass, it's gonna suck you in, spin you around, and your day's gonna be done. I was lucky enough to not touch the grass and to not have shrapnel hit the car. To run my first ever IndyCar race, you know, sixth place is an achievement that I'll have forever. I've got 600 more miles to go and do. This finish is nice. Let's keep building on it. It took 47 minutes to get from Indy to Charlotte. I felt like with the doctor and the nurse checking my vitals, plugging the IV in, giving me my next bottle of fluids, that I needed these people to help me with the next steps. That was my zone out of the 500 and zone in on the 600. Now when I got to Charlotte, everybody was very proud that a NASCAR guy could go up there and compete with those open wheel guys.
Kurt Busch now behind the familiar wheel of his Haas Automation Chevrolet.
We were in 15th. That's when I really started to settle in on, all right, we survived the first chunk of the race.
You see Kurt Busch in the 41. He's fighting to stay on the lead lap right now.
There was a lap that I remember around lap 136, and we weren't quite having the perfect day. I said, you know what, this is what soldiers do. You got to soldier on. It might be muddy, it might be dirty, it might be miserable. I'm not giving up. That's the part of doing 1,100 miles and executing perfectly all day. It's tough to do.
Well, it's been a long night in Charlotte for Kurt Busch. A left rear shock absorber problem.
That's part of motorsports, having mechanical failures. It takes perfect execution to win in this day and age.
His concern now is something completely different. He says he's down at least two cylinders in that 41 machine. Right now, he says it's not going to last much longer.
Kurt Busch's long day of racing Indianapolis and Charlotte is over. Kurt Busch has blown an engine.
It was quiet. Motor wasn't running. The 1,100 miles wasn't going to be achieved. And at the end of the day, I gave it my all. This was a 5-month journey.
I can't let the mood here with the car dampen what happened up in Indy today.
If you had to ask me right now, would I do it again? I'd love to do it again. No regrets at all.